Hello everyone, my name is Yash Vasant and I'm the Executive Director of BNI Ahmedabad. First of all, let me start off by wishing all of us a very, very happy financial new year. And I personally love new beginnings because there's always something new to look forward to, especially when it comes to BNI Ahmedabad. And the month of April is particularly interesting because we have two new developments which I'd love to take this time and share with all of us so that we're all kept in the loop. First and foremost, the most exciting news is that we have at least three new chapters which are going into formation in the month of April. One is already rounding up with its coffee tables, and two chapters should begin their coffee tables on the latter half of the month. I'm very proud of these developments because the vision of BNI Ahmedabad has been to change the way our city does business, and we are finally taking one step closer towards achieving that goal by having more referral partners, better members and quality members joining our team. That said, this is a great opportunity for us because we realize that it's not just about doing business with members in our chapter or the 50 or 70 people that we're associated with. It's very, very important that, and I'm sure all of us understand, that it's important to extend our limits in our understanding that the stronger our region is, the stronger the business that we do is, and that's what really makes the difference. And I'd also go as far as to say that why limit ourselves just to Ahmedabad, you know, go out there and do business with BNI India and meet the phenomenal people that exist as BNI members in our country today. And why limit ourselves to the country? Because there are more than 200,000 members across the world, and there are some really, really great potential businesses that exist for us sitting in Ahmedabad to do business with internationally. That said, if there are any particular people, your colleagues, your friends who've been wanting to get into BNI, especially in the hotcake categories, which have not been able to come in because of conflicts in existing chapters, this would be the best time to put them in touch with the office or with any of our launch directors if you do want to get them into a core group of a new chapter. Another development for this month is that we're starting, and I'm very, very happy first, let me tell you, that we had a few of our members who started to play cricket amongst each other inter-chapter. And that was taken so well, and a few of our members took the initiative to formalize it, and under the umbrella of BNI, we are officially having our BNI Ahmedabad's cricket tournament. Now, this tournament is scheduled to start on the 10th of April with its final match on the 14th of May. It's being held at the MK Farm and Gopi Farm, and all the matches are inter-chapter between chapter members. Now, any information that you need regarding the sponsorship, there are a lot of avenues to sponsor, and I think most of them are sold out. But there were avenues such as branding the back of the jersey or the sleeve of the jersey, and also title sponsorship, etc. If there are any of those particulars that you're interested in or particulars of the tournament, please do get in touch with your chapter's event coordinator, since they will be equipped with all the information to help you out. But I tell you all of this because it's important for me to share with you a question that we ask ourselves every single time that we think of doing any event in BNI Ahmedabad. And that simple question is, are we just doing a cricket tournament, or are we doing a world-class cricket tournament? And usually, in fact, not usually, but always, the unanimous answer that comes out from our core team as BNI Ahmedabad is that we're setting up a world-class tournament. And in order to do that, the only thing that ensures that we do something world-class is that all of us participate after understanding the why of us indulging in an event. Of course, we all love cricket and we appreciate the sportsmanship when the game is played, but the greater why that's served by doing this tournament is that today, sitting down, we realize that there are upwards of 650-700 members in BNI Ahmedabad, and there are not many of us who know more than even 20 or 25% of our entire region. And since talking about the power of the region, since I'm speaking to you today, it's very important that we all get together in tournaments such as these, and not just for the players that are playing the match, but for all of us as members. This is a great opportunity to get out there, show our support for our players, of course, but also take the opportunity to meet people from other chapters, families from other chapters, get to mingle with each other, and also eventually do business with each other through the relationships that we build. And finally, a huge congratulations to all our new LTs that have just taken their term this week. It's a phenomenal task to sit there, but first I want to congratulate you, each one personally. I know we've done it over and over at the handovers that you guys have been having, or we've been having as a region, but it's important that all of us appreciate and the task that you're about to embark upon. Because I promise you one thing, and I can't make many promises. The one I will make you, though, is that remember that the chair teaches us so much more than we will ever teach the chair. You know, being on that LT position for the next 6 months is probably the one time that we have an opportunity to lead a group of our peers. You know, we are not paying them to be led, or they're not paying us to lead. We are there because we lead by example, because we stand for a certain amount of values. We've shown excellence in our field. And that's why we have been chosen to be in that spot. And I know that each and every one of us, the presidents, the vice presidents, the secretary treasurers, members of the extended LT, each one of us is the best that there can be in that particular chapter at this point in time. That said, I did share the story at a couple of the handovers, and I wanted to share it with all of us because it's very important to me personally and to all of us as leaders or members to appreciate this one very subtle but important fact. And this fact is that nothing happens in isolation. And what I mean by that is, if you had a stonemason, think of a stonemason who takes a sledgehammer and is trying to break a huge boulder or a huge piece of stone or a huge rock, right? So if he takes a sledgehammer and hits the rock once, what do you think happens? Yeah, you're right. Absolutely nothing happens. Imagine he hits the stone again. Not even a crack. Nothing moves. He hits it again, fourth time and fifth time and then sixth time and then the tenth time, and absolutely nothing's moving. He does this for the 15th time and the 50th time and the 100th time, and there's no movement. He does it for the 500th time. He's been hitting it 500 times, no movement. He hits it for the 1,000th time and there's absolutely nothing. And we don't know when, but let's say, and let's imagine that the 1,201st time he takes the hammer, he goes to hit the rock, and the rock immediately splits in two. If you happen to be just looking at that point in isolation, you would say that, hey, look, this guy is so strong. What a great stonemason he is, or what a powerful man with a hammer he is, or what a brilliant hammer that is that broke that rock in one split second. In one shot, he broke the rock in two. Well, we know, since we know the entire story, that it wasn't that one shot that broke the rock, or that one hit that broke the rock in two. It was in fact 1,200 hits before that that aided in that one final blow that broke it in half. And why I share the story is with us today is because when the new LT is taking term, it is very, very important to be grateful to all those LT, especially the outgoing ones who have been hitting that rock for the past 6 months, or the 6 months before that, or the 6 months before that, because that rock is potentially going to break. I have a sneaking suspicion that this new term is going to be phenomenal for BNI Ahmedabad. This most smashing 6 months that we will have as a region. If we are going to have such a great term for the next 6 months, know that it was only because the platform was set and the rock had been hit so many times that this one time when we hit it, it may finally break. Also, know that apart from being grateful to them, we should be grateful to those that are going to now come and hit the stone, because let's say the stone doesn't break in the next 6 months. I don't know when it's going to break, but we know that it's going to break at some point. It might be in any LT term, but the time it breaks, it's not just that one person who made the difference, but it's all of the LTs, all of our members got together, hitting that stone over and over, that finally leads the stone to break. I also believe that over the next year, the year 2016 and 17, since it is a new beginning for us, is going to be the year that BNI Ahmedabad's metaphorical stone breaks. I know we've reached the status of the world's number one region, but I think there's a lot more work to be done, especially in terms of the business that we do and the quality that we generate, the quality of business that we generate for our members in our region today. We're doing, and I promise you that we're doing everything we can to ensure that we maintain the quality and culture that we represent, and at the same time keep hitting that rock to finally break it. So what I want to tell us all as members, and especially to the new LTs, is continue to hit that rock, and let's hit it with everything that we've got, because regardless if it breaks now or if it is going to break in the future, know that every single blow that we make is going to make a difference. And you never know, that one blow that you make now might be the final blow required for us to achieve everything that we've been wanting to achieve as BNI Ahmedabad, which is to really affect and change the way that Ahmedabad is doing business. Thank you so much for listening, guys. Again, this is Yash Vasant, Executive Director, BNI Ahmedabad.